then two other themes I'll just talk about briefly. One, obviously, 400 years of writing. You get a lot of history to these books, and you get the kind of social history that you expect, you know, the insight into kitchens at the time. But you also get a kind of glancing look at some big things that are going on in history. So if you look at, right in the middle, The Chef at War, is by Alexis Soyer, and he was a kind of Jamie Oliver of his day. He was a sort of campaigner, he was a grand celebrity chef, he cooked for the Reform Club. And then he was horrified, first of all, by famine in Ireland, and then by the plight of soldiers in the Crimea. And so he takes himself off to the Crimea to work with Florence Nightingale, and he teaches people in hospitals how to cook food decently for their troops. So he says things like, you know, when he says things to the cooks in Scutari Hospital, you know, when you're boiling up some meat, don't throw away the water afterwards, because it's soup, you know, it's good soup, it's nutritious and it's useful and it's for the keepers and everything. And he also invented a stone called the soil stone, which enabled the army to cook in the field. And I believe there's still a version of the soil stone being used today. So they could cook with very little fuel and no flame, no smoke visible. And the Raj, obviously the history of the Raj, you can see through Colonel Wyden we've talked about. And one of my favourites is a slightly, they're all one of my favourites, but this one in particular is my favourite. If you look at the very yellow one in the middle, it's Buffalo Cake and Indian Pudding, compiled by a man called Dr. Chase, who was an American, sort of a doctor, he wasn't really a doctor, he was a kind of snake oil salesman, you know, he sold patented medicine and that sort of thing. But what he did do, Bethan, was he collected recipes from all the way around Michigan, where he lived in about the mid-late 19th century. And you get to him this astonishing sense of this kind of burgeoning American pride and consciousness, but through food, that's what's so interesting. So there's a lot of competitiveness about, you know, Mrs. Kessler's hominy grits being better than anybody else's hominy grits, but the fact that they were American and not English, that can make them better still. And he says about one cake recipe, you know, he said, the person who sent me this recipe says it's fit for a king. He said, I said one better than that, it's fit for an American citizen. And so you have this kind of pride, really, in food.